Good morning, students. In previous video, we have finished our chapter number 5, and today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, mensuration. Students, in this chapter, we will discuss about our 2D figures like a rectangle, triangle, and square. And in this chapter, we will discuss how to find out the perimeter and the area of given figure. Okay, students? So let's start. First, we start with the perimeter. Okay? The perimeter of figure. How to find out the perimeter? Student, here the word perimeter, that means sum of all sides. Sum of all sides. So students, if any figure is given and we have to find out its perimeter. Perimeters, in another way we can say the length of its boundary. For example, here you observe this a green board, and if I have to find out the perimeter of this green board, then I have to add all the dimension, all the edges of this one, and then after I can get the total length of this boundary. So students, what is perimeter? Perimeter means total length of boundary of given figure. So in simple way we can say perimeter means sum of all sides. So this figure have a 4 sides because this figure in the shape of rectangle, and rectangle have the opposite sides equal. So these 2 sides are equal and these 2 sides are equal. So if we add this all 4 sides, then we can get the perimeter of this green board. So students, they have given the perimeter of the figures according to their shape. If the shape in the given of triangle, okay, the first, if they have given the shape in given triangle. So students, it's depend on triangle, which type of the triangle is it? If is it scallion triangle? Scallion triangle means all sides are different. Like this is A, this is B, and this C. That means all sides are different. So to find the perimeter, we denote the perimeter with the capital letter P. And we know very well, students, if any figure whose sides are different, to find its perimeter, simply add all the sides. So here we will write A plus B plus C. That's mean perimeter means sum of all sides. Okay. This is the first case. In second case, if the triangle is isosceles. Okay. If the triangle is isosceles. Isosceles means, students, 2 sides are equal. So if we write its dimension, we will write A and B. So students, if the 2 sides are equal and one side is different, so here the formula is 2A plus B. 2A plus B means we add this 2AA, 2A and plus B. Okay students, now in third case, if the triangle is equilateral, okay, the third case, triangle is equilateral. Equilateral triangles means all sides are equal. So that's mean A and A. How many times A comes? 3 times. So the formula is 3A. And this A is the length of side. So this formula will become 3A. So this is the perimeter of triangle. How to find the perimeter of triangle? We know the 3 type of the triangles on the base of their sides. First is scallion triangle. Scallion triangles means all 3 sides are different. So simply we add all the 3 sides and find out the perimeter. In the second situation, if the triangle is isosceles. Isosceles triangle means 2 sides are equal and one side is different. So we take the double of the 2 sides. For example, here is 5, then we will take 10 and 6. So 10 plus 6, 16. So 2A plus B, the formula. In third case, if the triangle is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means all 3 sides are same. So here we will apply the formula that the side multiply with 3. The formula will be 3A. A represent here the one side of the triangle. Now students, then after we are going to discuss the perimeter of rectangle. In the second case, perimeter of rectangle. Rectangle means a figure whose opposite sides are equal. That means this side equals to this one and this one equals to the opposite. So this, I already told, this green board is this example of rectangle. For this side is A. Otherwise, we will take, this is the length, so I represent with the L. This is the breadth, I represent with the B. So we know very well, the perimeter means sum of all sides. So 2 times L, L plus L. 2 times B, B plus B. So students, how many times L? 2 times. So we can write here 2L. How many times B? 2 times. So here we can write 2B. Which number is common between the both? 2. So we take the common 2 and inside the written L plus B. So this is the formula that we have derived from this one. What is the formula of find a perimeter of rectangle? 2 multiply length, L represent the length, plus breadth. Breadth means is this one side, okay? Okay, length plus breadth, and in short we can write 2L plus B. 2 multiply L plus B. So student, this is the formula to find the perimeter of rectangle. Now move to the third shape, that is our square. Okay, square, as we know, all sides are equal. Square, all sides are equal. So to find the perimeter, if the one side is A, then this one also A, this one also A, and this one also A. So how many times A? 4 A. So we can write 4 multiply by side. This is the formula to find the perimeter of a square. Okay students, now then after we are going to discuss about the regular figure. Students, what do you mean by regular figure? So I'm going to explain with the regular figure means whose all sides are equal. So this regular figures can be with the three side also, can be with four sides also, five also, and what the particular name we are using for that, that also I'm going to explain. The first, a figure with three equal side. If the three sides are equal, so here we use this one, equilateral. This is the three side figure we call equilateral triangle. If the four sides are equal, this figure said to be square. Okay. If five sides are equal. Okay, student, if the five sides are equal, then this figure called to be pentagon. Okay. And if the sides are equal, then we use a word regular. So if they will use, there is a figure regular pentagon. Regular pentagon means a figure whose all the five sides are equal. So students, whenever any regular figure is given, so how to find the perimeter of that regular figure? Count the number of sides. Here how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3. So the formula will be 3 multiply by side. Count here, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sides, so 4 multiply by side. Now in the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the formula of the perimeter will be 5 multiply by side. So same way students, we will move for the more sides. If the 6 sides are given, 6 multiply by side. 7 sides are given, 7 multiply by side. But keep remember, this formula will be apply in the case of regular figure only. Regular figure means whose all sides are equal. Understood students? Okay. Now then after we are going to discuss the word irregular figure. Irregular figure means whose sides are not equal. That means sides are different dimensions. Okay. If the figure is irregular, then what we will do? In that case, only we take the sum of all sides. For example, this. This is the one type of the figure. How many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 sides are there. But we observe, we can't tell the name of any figure of this one because all sides are different. Okay, so how to find the perimeter here? Then sum of all sides. What formula we will apply here? sum of all sides. So we will take the addition of all sides and we find out the perimeter here. So this formula we will apply in case of irregular figure. So students, have you understood about the regular figure and irregular figure? Regular figure means all sides are equal, and irregular figure means all sides are different. Understood? Okay. Now let's move to the next one. And I'm going to explain this one with the help of our exercise 13.1. In question number 13.1, they have given, write all the combination of length and breadth of a rectangle whose perimeter can be 20 meter. Okay. Now let's see how to solve this one. Exercise 13.1, question number first. Write all the combination of length and breadth of a rectangle. Student, which type of the figure they have given? Length and breadth. Okay. And its perimeter they have given to us, that is 20 meter. And we know very well the perimeter equals to 2 multiply length plus breadth. So here length plus breadth equals to perimeter divided by 2. This 2 shift this side, that's mean 20 by 2. That's mean the addition of length and breadth is 10. The sum of length and breadth is 10, 2. Any 2 length and breadth, their addition is 2. So write the combination of this one. How we get the 10? 8 and 2. So one side this can be 8 and this can be 2. Second combination, 7, 3. Then 9, 1. Students, we have to write the pair whose addition is 10 only. So 8, 2, 10, 7, 3, 10, 9, 1, 10. Then 6, 4, 10. Then 5 plus 5, 10. Okay. And in this way, we can change their sides. So this much pair we can write as like this, see, 4, 6, then 3, 7, then 8, 2, 8, and then 1, 9. So this much pair we can write of the length, and these are the length and this is the breadth, okay? So this, in this way we can write the pair. I repeat again in this question, they have given the perimeter of this figure is 20 and you have to find out the combination of its length and breadth whose perimeter is 20 in all the cases. So how many pairs can be? So this much pair can be, we write whose perimeter is 20. Okay students, now thereafter move to the question number second. In question number second, they have given five different type of the figure and we have to find out their perimeter. So let's see. The first figure they have given in the form of what we have to calculate here? Perimeter. Calculate P, perimeter. So the first figure is this shape. This is our first figure. One is 36 meter. Another one is 22 meter. Third side 45 meter. And fourth side is 25 meter. So students, have you observed all the four sides are different? So how to find the perimeter? We know the formula to find the perimeter, that means sum of all sides. So here we will take the addition, 36 plus 22 plus 45 then plus 25. So students, here we taken the addition and we will write here meter. So add this one, 5, 5, 10, 10, 10 to 12, 12 plus 6, 18. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11 plus 1, 12. So what is the perimeter of this one figure? 128 meter. Now take to the second figure. Second figure in the given in the shape of kite. And we have to find out perimeter from here. So student, this kite also an irregular figure. Irregular figure means all sides are different. 10, 10, 8, 8, 2, and 2, and this is 4. So to find the perimeter of this kite, we have to sum the all sides. So 10 plus 10 प्लस एट प्लस एट देन प्लस टू प्लस टू प्लस फोर वी हैव रिटन ऑल द साइड्स 10 प्लस 10 20 20 10 30 40 प्लस 4 44 मीटर स्टूडेंट्स वी विल गेट द सम ऑफ दिस ऑल साइड इज 44 मीटर ओके स्टूडेंट्स फॉर टुडे दिस मच ओनली एंड यू हैव टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 एंड 2 फुल इन योर रजिस्टर हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन इन रजिस्टर फर्स्ट ड्रॉ द फिगर एंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द फिगर यू हैव टू राइट द सॉल्यूशन ओके So you have to do this question number second also in your register. For today, this much only students and you have to learn the formula of how to find the perimeter of square and perimeter of rectangle, perimeter of triangle and what will be the formula in case of regular figure and what will be the formula in case of irregular figure. So this all things you have to learn. So what's your homework today? Learn the formulas and Then after you have to solve question number 1 and 2 of your exercise 13.1. For today, this much only. Thank you, students.